Frilled and horned dinosaurs, what did they use these things for? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University teaching the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. In this video, I'll introduce you to the anatomy of the weird and bizarre frilled horned dinosaurs belonging to the ceratopsian group. In particular, the big North American ceratopsian dinosaurs like Triceratops here. The skull features two major modifications from what we saw in earlier dinosaurs. The squamosal bones expanded posteriorly, and the parietal bones are equally enlarged to encompass the frill of the skull of large ceratopsian dinosaurs. Now, along the margin of the frill are horny growths called epoccipitals, which in some dinosaurs are enlarged to form horns of their own. Often older individuals reduce the extent of the epoccipitals, and the bone will be reabsorbed as a source of calcium, kind of like elderly people's bones becoming more weak as they get older. The jugal or cheekbone is expanded as well, with a broad projection called the epjugal. The horns can grow out of the postorbital or nasal bones, depending on which species we're talking about. Note that ceratopsians have two new bones unique to the group, the rostral bone and the predentary, which form a beak. The angular and circangular bones of the lower jaw are fused into the coronoid bone in the lower jaw. But the rest of the skull bones are basically what we saw with the earlier dinosaurs. There's an incredible diversity of ceratopsian dinosaur skulls, from the early hornless protoceratopsians to the giant North American ceratopsians like Triceratops. So what was this frill and these horns used for? Well, there's been three hypotheses put forth. The first is that they were used as defense from predators. The second is that they prevented interspecific mating as a way for species to recognize each other. And this is a bit like what modern African antelope use their horns for, is to sort of identify which species they belong to for mating. And the third hypothesis is that they were used for interspecific fighting behavior. So this would be where individuals of the same species would fight each other for mates and for social dominance in the herd. One of the most interesting studies came out with the work of Andrew Farkey and colleagues, who studied Triceratops and Centrosaurus skulls. And what they did is documented the any evidence they saw of skull damage on the skulls. They found that the jugal and squamosal and parietal bones all had indications of battle scars of damage, with the jugal having the largest percent of damage observed in all the bones. Now, this led them to propose that the horns and frills were used in interspecific fighting, when individuals would lock horns with other individuals of the same species. The frills could also be used for other functions, but this was the first line of evidence that these dinosaurs used their frills and horns in combat with each other. Alright, you should now be able to sketch and illustrate the various parts of the ceratopsian frill and how they may have functioned in life.